Hey, I'm Eddie, and this is Super C. On a Nintendo, three lives, no continue. See how it goes. Already failed once. It's been, I'd say about a year since I played this game. I'm not playing it very safe at the moment. Certainly wasn't playing very safe the last run I just did. Man, I'm terrible. Flame gun. Ooh, that was close.
Oh, that.
Cats. Yay, spread! Spread your legs and shoot! Boss time. This is going so much better than the last run. I have a weapon at the boss. Oh. Yay, I didn't have to go through that whole cargo enemy unloading bullshit. I like how the sunset just appears in that one section. Area 2. A lot of people don't like the top-down levels in Contra games. I'm one of them. This one's okay. Super Contra, yeah, wasn't terrible in the top-down perspective. As hard as the Nintendo Super C is, the one for arcade is like 10 times harder. It's one of the most unforgiving, hardest, cheapest, most frustrating games I think I've ever played. Would it suck if there was, like, a real thing, like, you could just use and instantly kill you, like, like, say you're on the battlefield and some guy has, like, a remote device that can just instantly vaporize you no matter where you're at, just in your, he's in your proximity.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
What do you mean, he's like part of a game or what?
No, like in real life. Like if you're a, you know, one of these devices that kill all the enemies on the screen, you know, like if that was real,
oh, yeah.
You got that, you're just fucked. You're like, ah, oh no! You just vaporize.
Yeah. Maybe more, a little bit more personal, just a bomb, because you can see the guy coming.
Yeah, you can actually see your murderer before he touches the item. Ooh, rapid fire. Rapid fire with spread is awesome.
Yeah. What's your least favorite weapon?
No doubt, the laser.
It's weird to use, isn't it?
Laser sucks, and I think maybe there's one Contra game where the laser is the best weapon in the game. Ironically enough, that game doesn't even have the word Contra in its title. Whoa, I barely ducked that one. The Amazon. You ever notice there's a lot of levels about Amazon in Nintendo games?
I never thought about it, but I guess so.
I just noticed that. I mean, this level doesn't say Amazon, but you know.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I know what you mean. Like, it does have like a feeling like you're in South America somewhere in the jungle.
Like, Ninja Gaiden 1 and 3 had that kind of.
Yeah. There's one level is like swampy type area, and was that in 1 or 3?
Yeah, it was in 1 and 3.
1 and 3.
I played 3 recently, and when you discover Foster again, the next stage is like the same kind of area, so maybe it doesn't really say, but maybe Ryu decides he wants to go back to Foster's little area.
Oh, yeah, I forget what the story is, but, like, he wants to go back.
That game has a terrible story.
See, I always liked the story of 3. Not because it's brilliant, I just thought it was cool.
What the fuck killed me? There was nothing that fucking should have killed me right there. Now I gotta fight this fucking...
I wasn't watching.
Oh, ridiculous.
Maybe you can reason with him.
This thing?
Yeah.
Me, good guy. You, bad guy. Come to understanding that good is good and bad is bad. No? He's still firing at me.
Darn. Maybe you can seduce him.
Well, maybe we'll try that another time.
Show him how many setups you can do. A push-up, whatever.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Oh, I'm tired, dude. Man. Do you remember the names of the Contra guys?
No.
Scorpion and Mad Dog.
Really?
Oh, Mad Dog.
Scorpion and Mad Dog? I wouldn't have guessed. Of course, I don't know what I would have guessed. But...
I think that was their code names. They had, they had like Bill and Lance were their names. And Bill and Lance, and then Mad Dog and Scorpion. I think Scorpion was the player 2 guy, and Mad Dog was the first guy.
What would you think if you met some guy, maybe like the first or second time you met him? He's like, "Hey, everybody calls me Stank Dog. Just call me Stank Dog."
Well, what's up, man? I'm Stank Dog.
I saw a guy do that on a television show, some reality show, and they were like being interviewed or something, and he's like, this isn't the first episode, but he's gonna say he's changing his name to Stank Dog. He's like, "Well, everybody just call me Stank Dog now." He's like some fat white guy.
Oh, it's a white guy?
Yeah, it's a white guy. I think he's like a long beard or something. There's like some kind of like fancy, well-spoken type. He might have even been British reporter there. And he's like, "Okay, Stank Dog." And he went on talking about whatever they were talking about. You know, this cracks me up this day every once in a while. I think of that, how ridiculous that is.
You calling Stank Dog ridiculous? That reminds me of, I don't know why it reminds me of. It reminds me of Ill Mitch for some reason.
I remember that guy. I thought that was funny when it popped up on Facebook. Fast in Danger, something like that.
Yeah, my rhyme is Fast in Danger or something, I don't know.
His skateboarding or something. He was like a big skateboarder, dude.
Yeah, I'm sure he was.
I heard that Peppa from Salt and Peppa likes to be called Peppa all the time.
I'm sure she does.
It'd be kind of weird if somebody's like, could you call me Peppa? Peppa? No, Peppa. Peppa.
Red Falcon, the forces are invading. What should we do? Send out the bubbles.
Who was that from?
From this.
Send out the bubbles.
Oh, those enemies.
Yeah.
What you're talking about.
What should we do, sir? The bubbles.
Those things always, like, I kind of wondered about them, like, what they're supposed to be, what they look like in real life. Yeah, they do look like a bubble, but they also look like some kind of, like, energy egg or something. Like an egg of pure energy.
Pure energy.
Pure energy.
I wanna know. But no, maybe they have filled with some sort of poisonous gas.
Yeah, it could be nearly anything around.
Maybe it's a fart that Red Falcon sealed up in there.
That round thing in the middle is actually a hunk of shit.
It's just the fart vapor.
Just the pure essence of his fart.
Blast Scorpion with my fart bubble.
Another person we all got, like that whale I saw on TV today getting lanced. This is a dead whale. They like come stranded on the beach and died. They've been dead for a while. The guy's like poking a spear into it. And when it blew Fuck. Open, it just like blew. It just kept. It blew a bigger hole in itself. And it was like blowing its guts out and everything with gas escaping.
Aww.
I bet that smelled really good. Everybody around was holding their nose.
You fucker!
There's one guy smoking a pipe, though. He didn't seem to mind. He was one of the guys, like, right there jabbing a machete in it.
He's like, fascinating.
It's like, well, some of that putrid stuff blows into my pipe bowl, it enhances the flavor.
I've never had tobacco taste like this.
God damn it! Oh my goodness, man, this guy's just shooting at me. Yay, extra man. I need it, I think. I've been dying a lot. These dudes are some of Red Falcon's elite forces. He's like, send out the Pink Guard or the Purple Guard.
Yeah, God damn, these guys are elite anything. It's like, these are like run in one direction type guys. I guess if they hit a wall, do they turn?
Yeah. They're like, run for him. Don't stop for nothing. Run, run, run. Run into him. And if you miss, turn around and run again.
These skulls are pushing her.
Oh.
If you beat Woo! This, some scorpion should say, those are the fakest skulls I've ever seen.
He's like, I'm bad. Oh, that's a different game. You motherfucker. Let me speak to your mother. I like this level, except we got those weird things that pop up in the fucking bottom of the ground that you really can't do shit about. I'm always guaranteed to lose a life there.
Yeah.
Oh! Well, not what I want, but it's better than nothing. Well, there's an extra life. That's what I'll use for not making it past this part without. Whoa! See? Fuck that. So stupid.
So they're not here. They're like, right in your stomach or something.
Oh yeah. Ooh, I really needed this.
That's good.
Oh, that one almost got me. You know, this is the last level in the arcade, but there's another level in the NES version. This pussy up ahead is the final boss in the arcade. Oh, fuck, he killed me! This guy never kills me!
He's a pretty thing, isn't he?
He's beautiful. What the hell is going on? This guy's never that hard.
6 eyes and 5 mouths. His eyes really are bigger than his stomach. Oh, he's his mouth. That was stupid.
Oh no, what's going on? The ground is shaking. Oh.
Was this on the arcade?
Yeah, this was the last boss. I was thinking about it, this game actually has two other stages. I guess, you know, especially a lot of Konami games, they put more levels into them and whatnot than the arcades had. I guess they figured that they had to, you know, put a little bit more into the games if you were going to be charging $50 for them and bringing them home. Plus, yeah. The graphics never were as good, so...
Yeah, I guess I got.
Bullet sponges. Wait a minute, this level was in the arcade, but it was, Contras did something weird in the arcade. Both of them had, especially the first one had long level that was maybe three levels of the Nintendo, but it was one long level of the different environments on the arcade. Surprised that didn't kill me. Laser, hell no. Ah. I'm going down in his esophagus. That's what I always thought this was, like a throat or something. Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, but I really wanted the damn rapid with a spread. No, I don't.
Does that one look like me? Oh, you know, there's a whole lot like the things from Alien. They spit out the one, except they only spit out one.
Yeah, there's a lot of Alien type stuff in, you know, this game. This guy's always been weird to me, and easy, but weird. Well, he's easy if you got a spread gun.
Yeah.
It's kind of like the thing in the first game at the waterfall. Not as cool, though. Last stage. 5 lives left. Looks like I beat it without continuing. As long as I'm not too careless on this stage. Damn, no rapid fire. Now the aliens show their true form now. I'm so close, they don't have to wear human disguises on these stages.
Oh, were those aliens before?
Yeah.
I did not know
that. Ooh, rapid fire. Oh yeah, it's on, motherfuckers. Hate that jump.
You know, like a certain percentage of people believe that the world is run by reptile aliens in disguise as humans.
Really?
Or at least some of it. Some political offices and stuff like that.
Man, if that was only the case, the world would be so much more fucking interesting. Well, the camera didn't shut off. So my proof of no continue here, I guess, will be recorded in the annals of history.
Oh my goodness, I almost crushed
you. Oh my god. The only thing I worry about is the bubbles up there.
Can you remember the first time you come through here and how that affected you?
Yeah, I'm like,
you like pooped
your pants? Shit, I'm dead.
I don't remember if I've even been here or not.
It's the bubbles that kill you because you can't shoot through the wall.
Mm-hmm.
Fuck you. You gotta kill as many of them as you can before they... Oh.
That looks vaguely. Good. Oh. So close. Good one. More of this shit.
More of this shit. This is the last level, so that's why it's pretty difficult here.
Oh, we saved.
Thank you, sir. I think it drops even more. Maybe not. Sometimes those things...
That's a good pause there.
No, this is it. That one last goon. The wall is revealed to be Red Falcon!
Oh, that thing.
This is the hardest end boss in video game history, dude.
Really?
Here we go.
That doesn't look like it'd be even hard, even if you have a spread gun.
It's not. Even if you have the regular gun, it's easy as hell. You just shoot up every now and then, you know? Super C!
Well done.
Off into the sunset. Another mission accomplished. Job well done, boys. Y'all can go drink some Coors.
Scorpion and Mad Dog going off to Spank Dog for a beer.
Actually, I think they retire after this game.
Oh, really?
Yeah, because in Contra 3, it's, 4,000 fucking years into the future or some shit.
Oh.
Yeah, like, you are descendants of Mad Dog and Scorpion. I'm not kidding.
You're not kidding.
I'm not fucking kidding.
That is precious.
Like, these characters here from the first two Nintendo games were so evolved, Mad Dog and Scorpion as characters were so evolved that like even though basically their 16-bit versions were the same fucking thing, like they had to, no, it couldn't be Scorpion and Mad Dog for the third time. No, we've got to create whole new characters. Ridiculous. So.
And like the weapons and enemies are a lot the same.
Yeah. You got the laser, and you got the freaking, some of them, you got the homing weapons and whatnot. But for the most part, yeah, it's the same kind of stuff. So, Super C, thanks for watching. I appreciate it.